Hello and welcome. My name is Amanda. Today we're going to go over Surya Namaskar, or a sun salutation. A sun salutation is often set in the beginning of a flow to help you warm up and prepare for your practice. It's also a great building block to add to the rest of your practice or to add more advanced poses. The sequence I'm going to go over today is the very basic sun salutation, and I'll include modifications as well as more advanced options if you're ready to continue your practice. Begin your sun salutation at the front of your mat in Tadasana or mountain pose with your feet side by side. Lift through your legs, your pelvic floor, your belly, your spine, and the crown of your head. Your shoulders and your shoulder blades rest down and on your back. Hands are down by your side. Inhale to sweep your arms overhead, big stretch up. As you lift up, make sure your spine stays tall, your belly stays engaged to support your back. Use an exhale to fold forward, bringing your hands down to your legs or down to the floor. Let there be a gentle slope through your entire spine. Inhale, lengthen your spine, making a flat back. So this either can be done with your hands down on the ground or your fingers touching your mat or your hands on your low legs or on your thighs. Lift up through your belly. Use an exhale to bring your hands back down to the mat. Bend your knees as much as you need to and step back to downward facing dog. This is our upside down V shape. Palms press into the mat. Thighs lift up. Inhale to plank pose. You're welcome to stay up tall or drop down on your knees. In either position, lift up through your belly, press down through your palms. Take another breath. And then exhale, bend your elbows, lower all the way down to the mat. Inhale, lift up into cobra, keeping your elbows pointed back down towards your hips. Exhale, lower, tuck your toes under, lift your belly, and press all the way back to downward facing dog. Breathe in. Exhale, step your right foot forward. Inhale. Exhale, step your left foot forward, moving back into forward fold. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, sweep your arms up, standing tall. And then exhale, hands back down in Tadasana. Now, if we want to add a little bit more to that, we're going to make this a little bit more challenging. So inhale, sweep your arms overhead. Exhale, fold down. Inhale, lengthen through your spine, flat back. Exhale, step back to downward facing dog. Inhale to plank, this time keeping your knees up. As you exhale, lower and then lift on an inhale into upward facing dog. In upward facing dog, just your palms and the tops of your feet touch the mat. Breathe in, lift through your belly, exhale, lift your hips and press your heels back. Downward facing dog. Inhale. Exhale, step your right foot forward. Inhale. Exhale, step your left foot forward. Inhale, lift, flat back. And then exhale, fold down. Inhale, sweep your arms overhead, stand tall. And then exhale, hands back down by your side. Now one more variation to increase this or make it a little bit harder. So here we go. Inhale, reach up. Overhead. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen through your spine. Exhale, hands plant. Bend your elbows, lift up through your belly, and hop back to downward facing dog. Make sure that your elbows stay bent. Your elbows form a spring to support your shoulders in that jump. Inhale to plank. Exhale, lower chaturanga. Inhale, lift. Up dog. And then exhale back to downward facing dog. As we prepare to jump forward, the same thing. Your elbows are going to be soft, shoulders soft, knees soft. Breathe in, lift up through your belly, and as you exhale, hop forward. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. And then inhale, sweep your arms overhead, stand tall. Exhale, hands down by your side. Now let's say you want to take it down several notches, or you're just really beginning your practice. So here's an option for that. Or if you have any knee or hip issues going on. Inhale, sweep your arms overhead. Exhale, fold forward. Keep your hands on your legs or your thighs. Nice, gentle slope through your spine. Inhale, lengthen your spine, flat back. Exhale, hands come down, bend your knees a lot, and step to hands and knees. Inhale into cow back, reaching your belly towards the ground. Lift your chin and chest. Exhale, round your back into cat. Inhale back to neutral. And then exhale, step your right foot forward. Inhale. Exhale, press into your right foot, step your left foot forward. Inhale, lengthen your spine again. Exhale, fold down. Inhale, sweep your arms overhead, stand tall. Exhale, hands down by your side. Inhale, sweep your arms overhead, stand tall, lift up, lifting through your belly, your chest. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lengthen, flat back. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your right leg high. Exhale, step it forward between your hands. Bring your back heel down to the mat. Press through both feet as you inhale, sweep your arms overhead. Find your warrior one. Exhale, fold down, step back, downward facing dog. Inhale to plank. Exhale, bend your knees, elbows and lower. Inhale, lift, upward facing dog. And then exhale, back, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your left leg high. Exhale, step it forward between your hands. Drop your right heel to the mat. Inhale, lift your arms overhead, hips work towards pointing towards the front of your mat. Exhale, fold forward. Step back, downward facing dog. Inhale to plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, lift up dog. And then exhale, downward facing dog. Big deep breath. And then exhale, step or hop to the front of your mat. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reach arms overhead. Exhale, hands down by your side. Adding mat warrior two. Inhale, sweep up. Exhale, fold. Bending your knees to support your hamstrings if you need to. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your right leg high. Exhale, step it forward between your hands and set your left heel down on the mat. Inhale, reach your arms overhead. As you exhale, open to warrior two. Back foot now parallel to the back of your mat. Front knee stays centered over your ankle. Rib cage is sitting directly on top of your pelvis. Look over that front middle finger. Breathe in. Exhale, hands down to frame your foot. Lift your back heel and step your front leg back behind you, downward facing dog. Inhale to plank. Exhale, lower your belly to the mat. Inhale, lift cobra or up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift your left leg high. Exhale, step it forward between your hands and softly turn your right heel to the mat. Inhale, reach your arms overhead. Find warrior one. Exhale, open to warrior two. Breathe in. And then exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale to plank. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. Exhale, downward facing dog. Big breath in. And then exhale, step or hop to the front of your mat. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reach your arms overhead, stand tall. Exhale, hands by your side. Stay, hold, and breathe. You can pause here and notice the warmth in your body. Take one more breath. Exhale, let it go. Roll through your shoulders and your head right to left. So that was a lot of variations of the Surya Namaskar. So lots of places to build, lots of places to take it back if you're ready to take it back or need to. due to knee injury, hip injury, or even your shoulder, so taking out the downward facing dog or your chaturanga. One thing I do want to note, and I didn't go over a lot today, is how to do a chaturanga. So with chaturanga, your hands are directly underneath your shoulders. So we're here, we're coming down, and your chest is actually moving forward as you come down towards the mat. So you're not putting all the pressure in the fronts of your shoulders. Stay tuned for more information on chaturanga. Thanks so much for joining me today. See you soon.